Charlie Hill Metals hockey career began in 1979 when he sold even splits hockey tickets in the New Waterford rink for Archie McIntyre and Dale Kearney. The sale of these tickets was very important as funds helped to finance the New Waterford Jets junior hockey team. Later on, when the Jets were taken over by Spike Gillis, Ray McDougall, and Sonny Brown, Charlie became the manager of the Jets. And during those years, fostered many players, among them Bernie Timmons, Daryl Jennings, Swish Cheshon, Lawrence Smith, Brian DeVoe, and Michael Gillis. In later years, he partnered with Frank Seward to co-own the Sydney Junior Millionaires and spend the remainder of his hockey career as manager of the team. Later, that team changed their name to the Cape Breton Alpines and welcomed players from all over Cape Breton. In 1987-88, the highlight of Charlie's management was the year of the Dream Team. Charlie, together with the coaching team of none other than Roger Kuzner and Ronnie Bowden, enjoyed the thrill of 32 wins and no losses that entire season. The Cape Breton Alpines team was introduced to the Cape Breton Sports Hall of Fame in 1988. Charlie very deservedly received the Hockey Nova Scotia President's Award in the 90s for outstanding promotion of junior hockey in Nova Scotia. He also received the Hockey Canada Award in 1994 for his outstanding volunteer career promoting junior hockey. Charlie served 2 years as chairman of the Board of Governors for the Nova Scotia Junior B Hockey League. Charlie had an incredible eye for the best players and certainly for the best coaches. He is responsible for coaches of the caliber of Roger Bobbitt, Bruce Campbell, Kenny Tracy, Ray McDonald, Chris Nenas, and for 2 years, former Russian and Cape Breton Oilers goalie, Sasha Tishnik. In 1997, Charlie brought the Don Johnson Cup to the New Waterford rink in 1998. They played against the NHA All-Stars at Center 200. I will now ask Charlie Neville to come and accept the award.